Kelly Wigglesworth, a river guide from Las Vegas.
He was yelling at everybody, let's lose the box, cut it loose now. He may be 72 years old and an ex-Navy SEAL, but that doesn't mean that this is his world. We got the tribal council tonight.
Pack your bags, get ready to go. Which one it will be, the world will soon know.
Unfortunately, we're gonna have to vote somebody off. There's gonna be a lot of tension, and one of us is gonna leave.
First person voted off the island. Sonya. The tribe has spoken.
Fishing, I think we've been doing, you know, what we're supposed to do. We've collected hermit crabs, we put them in the traps, we rafted them out. You know, if we can just catch the one fish, then we can use that as bait and we'll catch more.
Here we go, guys. 3, 2, 1, eat!
Go, 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 go!
Keep forgetting where I am when I wake up. This is frustrating. I mean, it's the ocean. You think you'd get a fish somehow, but no luck so far. We all thought, oh yeah, you know, we got these traps, we got hooks, we got a raft. You know, there's no reason why we shouldn't be having big fat fish for dinner every night, but we're just not. To me, that's kind of like, yeah. Woohoo, big survivors, you know? I think we were all kind of stoked that, you know, yeah, he's an ex-Navy SEAL. We're gonna kick ass, but he really hasn't contributed very much. I think it's definitely gonna influence me the next time I go to tribal council. I think it's influencing all of us, you know? Stacy came up to me, yeah, I think he likes you, you know? I was just like, oh, great. You know, I didn't come out here for that. You know, we don't need that. I think he's really sexually frustrated.
I mean, I've gone 23 years without sex. I think you guys can go 7 weeks.
Yeah. I want a year.
Oh, my God. You should try it. You should try it sometime. You might like it.
It's just funny. When
you might like I know you'll like it.
No, and then I know just, I'm going to love it.
You'll come back.
It's
come
a
back.
Gift from God. There's no doubt, man.
I'm obviously not a virgin. If he, that's how he wants to live his life, that's cool. You don't meet too many 23-year-old guys who are virgins. I don't think it's gonna get any easier. You know, every time we go there, it's just gonna suck even more. I don't think anybody's out here to make friends. I'm not out here to make friends. The people that you're forming alliances with now and the people that you're getting along with now are the people that are gonna have to turn around and vote you. But somebody's gotta go, so it's just the way it goes.
Stacy. Well, the weather has spoken, and the tribe has spoken.
The whole idea of an alliance is to make sure we're all voting the same way. Sue and I had discussed on our own about getting Richard in the same vote and us three having the same vote.
So no matter what, if we never talk again, the next vote is?
Because the more people you know that are gonna vote for somebody else, you might as well go with that. You might as well, you know, keep yourself safe and, you know, keep it in the majority.
It could be.
Oh, yeah.
We really like Rudy. You know, Rudy's kind of crabby, but he's a lot better to get along with, you know, than the two boys. At least he's honest. You know, he'll tell you, you know, up yours in a second.
Sue!
Me, personally, I was a little irritated with Sean and Dirk's effort around camp. I mean, they try to go out fishing when they know they're not gonna catch anything, and I think, personally, it's just so they can say, hey, well, we did something. It's been the people who really work and contribute to camp versus the people who are lazy and don't really do anything to contribute to the camp.
I'd rather eat some eel than some chicken. See, at least we eat stuff that we go out and catch and look for ourselves, and we don't have it handed to us.
We thought it was just gonna be, you know, big fat steaks and meat, but it really wasn't. We've noticed Dirk kinda getting a little skinny. There was a few days where we were all kind of concerned about him, and he was just kinda
I think, you know, mentally he was a little bummed out, and all of us were like, you know, eat more rice. But we all kind of try and keep an eye on him because he was real skinny to begin with, you know.
Any other dishes? I'm going out.
We got that.
Anybody else?
The labor thing, it's actually better now. John and Dirk started to realize that they better, you know, do something, otherwise they're out of here.
Today is day 15, and we have an immunity challenge today. I'm a commercial whitewater raft guide, so obviously I'm the rower today. Feeling a little pressure, but not too worried about it. I know Jervis can't swim, so my guess is that they're gonna put him in the boat rowing, which is cool for me because I could beat him any day of the week.
No, get up here!
That is the worst!
I got beat by a guy who can't even swim.
Yeah, but he wasn't swimming.
Yeah. Go, Kelly. I can't believe that I lost that.
Tonight we have to take the suck fest hike to the tribal council, and we get to vote somebody off tonight, unfortunately.
You know, despite everything, I was the best choice to put in that boat today. And, you know, like I said, sometimes your best just isn't good enough, and life just wouldn't be life if everybody didn't get their little embarrassments from time to time, so.
That which doesn't kill you makes you stronger, right, Sean?
Absolutely. I say that to myself all the time.
Kelly, tell me about morale. Two tough losses back to back.
Personally, for me, today was really hard. Coulda, shoulda, woulda, a lot of things. You know, I said some things at the beach, whatever. Not making excuses, not trying to, not going to. You know, I gave it my best day and just wasn't good enough. So, ate a little crow. It's all right. Doesn't mean I have to like it.
Tribe has spoken.
I think it'll be cool when we merge. I think they're nice people. I don't think they're taking this seriously. They're playing Island 90210. They think that they're gonna go to their little mud volcano and give each other facials, and they don't need to really do anything because they're just here to look cute on TV. I don't know.
He walks around naked quite a bit. I think it probably bugs some of the guys.
Come on, go, 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 go,
go, go, go,
Jenna's sincere. I believe Jenna's sincere, and I think Gretchen's sincere. But Jenna is young and not a mature young like you. She's young. It's
just babbling. She's young and flaky.
She wants to be proud for her children. Proud for your children, win.
She's just really happy
Show your girls what it's about and how to win.
You know who's next,
don't you? Who, after Greg?
Jenna. I was thinking Sean.
Oh, yeah.
He's too much competition, and he will not participate.
God, I'm glad I'm on your team.
Yeah, baby.
Didn't come here to...
Yeah.
Make so friends. Off. It's almost too good. Like, everybody's too, like, oh, you go first. No, you go first. You know, everybody's being real, real super polite, you know, which is cool. I suggested that we should, you know, beef up the supports and everything. Okay, which, you know, I don't know. I don't know anything about shingles and roofing, and I just know how to tie knots. That's pretty much all I know how to do. No. And bam. Shingles break, the whole roof comes crashing down. Felt like such an idiot. Gretchen said she drank a fifth of whiskey in 2 minutes when she was 14, and that's, I would have never guessed that about her, you know? Sounds like we kind of have a similar past.
Lewis, close, very close.
When you get in that tribal council and you walk up and you see that little piece of paper and the thing that you put the vote in, it's all different. You know, you might have a thought and say, hey, I really don't want to vote this person off. It's easier said than done. An alliance is easier said than done.
Gretchen, I need you to bring me your torch.
Travis spoken.
This is a game, and don't take it personally. You know, people came here to make, you know, bosom buddies and, you know, lifelong friends. They should have gone to summer camp.
We're all hungry, and we're low on energy, and there's still no one else providing any food except for Rich. And we're having to ration the rice. You know, I see him as being a chameleon, changing his colors to fit whoever he's around. The reward is going to be something from home, and Jenna's thinking it's our pictures that we got to bring, and she misses her daughters terribly.
Hi, Kelly. I know you're doing good. You're probably going to win, but I miss you anyway. I'm ready for you to come home, so eat your rice, keep smiling, and come home. Let's go kayak. I'm ready to go. Peace.
I don't know.
I felt so bad for Jenna. She practiced all morning on that stupid bow and arrow, and then it was just like, why bother for her?
I feel like I feel every tribal council, only it gets worse every time. I feel like a backstabber. I feel like a liar.
How do you, you know, stay true to yourself and maintain integrity and still play this game? And you know what? You can't. I keep telling myself, oh, I have enough friends. I didn't come here to make friends and, you know, da da da. And the truth is, I like these people.
Kelly, same question.
Do I have to answer? No, I'm just kidding.
Has your voting strategy changed now, or will it change tonight?
I vote for who I don't particularly like. I vote for who I don't want to spend the next 15 days with.
Greg.
No!
Greg, the tribe has spoken.
This whole alliance thing is getting too stupid and too crazy. If we stick with it, it's just like lining lambs to the slaughter. Who goes next? Who goes next? That's no fun.
We were targeted already anyway.
I know.
If we keep annoying them like we are, we're going to be gone really soon.
Yeah, I don't like it. I'm not happy playing the game that way. If I'm going to win, if I'm going to really be the last survivor, if I'm really going to survive and really do this, then it has to be on my own. The hardest part now is food. We're hungry, and Rich is the only one that can fish. We've gone fishing in the morning, we've gone in the afternoon, we've gone at night. We're not catching any fish. It bothers me that I can't get my own food, that I have to rely on someone else.
Sean's going around telling everybody, don't be in alliance, don't vote your conscience. Meanwhile, he's going around preaching everyone to vote their conscience, and he's like, oh, okay, alphabetically.
Good job, Rudy.
There you go.
Yeah.
Hang tight, buddy. We're going to be taking that talisman in a minute. You win.
I probably will have the swing vote tonight. I'd said before, you know, alliance or no alliance, there's two people that I have in mind to vote off, and they're two people that are competition, but they annoy me, and they're kind of sucky to live with.
The last vote, Jay. Jenna, the tribe has spoken.
It's weird the day after anybody leaves, there's just this void of, oh wait, you know, someone's not here. The only person I trust is Sue, and sometimes I doubt that. You know, it's getting to that point where you don't know who you can trust. This is not what I thought it was going to be like. It's not about surviving elements. It's about surviving yourself. I didn't want to be part of the alliance because I thought it was conniving and dirty and untrue to myself. It's not worth it to feel like shit for the rest of your life, for a little bit of money and your 15 minutes. You know, I kind of feel like Luke Skywalker or something. I crossed over to the dark side for a moment. I don't like playing the game that way.
Does it feel pretty, like it fits your face okay?
Making a deal with Rich is kind of like making a deal with the devil.
Then do you know how to use it, to breathe, or no?
I decided a while ago not to be part of the big alliance. And I've been pretty much letting Rich think that I'm still part of his little
mind game follower thing the whole time, basically, because I figured if I did, you know, tell him that I grew a conscience and I didn't want to be his little follower anymore, that he would turn around and shut me down, which I'm certain he would have, so I'm glad I didn't tell him. Do I just kind of roll over and let Rich decide how it's all going to play out, or do I try and beat him at his own damn game?
We got it!
Oh, good job, Rich.
I could cook some rice over here, though, if you want me to.
I was talking to Colleen, and we were just like, this sucks. You know, especially for her and Jerv. It's like they know they're leaving next, so they're just going to sit around and wait, you know, with a red dot pointed to their head. Or something exciting would happen, something shocking, something that nobody expects.
Kelly, we haven't talked much about your strategy in terms of voting. You got to have one at this point, I'm
thinking. Sure, why not? I think everybody does.
What is it? What's it based on?
It's based on who's competition and who's pissing me off.
Jervis. Tribe has spoken.
People were kind of miserable this morning because I was one of the miserable. I mean, every day is a little tough because we don't have a lot to do and we're low energy. I think Rich has gotten really, really weak and really crabby and really hungry, and Sean also. Colleen's legs are pretty beat up. She's got some pretty bad gashes, and she has some sores up higher on her legs that she doesn't know how she got. I'm here to play the game. I'm gonna play the game. I don't give a rat's ass what people think about me. I don't have to prove anything to anybody. I know who I am, so who cares? I really like Sean. I probably talked a lot of trash about Sean because he's neurotic and talks a lot, but he's really a good guy. If he does get to bring one person, he said he's gonna bring me, so I'm a little stoked up about that. I might get to go spend a night on a yacht, which would be cool, because if I could spend a night on a yacht and shower and eat some food, I'd be good to go for another 7 days. That piece of crap parachute thing has been the most waterproof thing we've had on this whole island, so a lot of people have been crowding up underneath that. Thank God for the sun. So the sky's really clear and everybody's drying out and warming up. Good stuff. Sean kept saying how he was gonna take me, and then last minute he said, oh, Rich, you like eggs for breakfast, don't you? Okay, me and you, Rich, I'll take you.
You guys dumb.
Hey, tell Sean he's in big trouble. Tell Sean he's gotta deal with Wigglesworth when he gets back.
Oh, that'll spoil his whole morning.
Food that he's, you know, I don't even give
a, that's the food. Point
it's
of
the,
it.
It's the point that he's been going on and on and on about how
he screwed you out of a deal.
How he screwed me and he owes me, and then when it comes down to it, he can't even. Alliance thing. I don't even care about that anymore. You know, I say I'm not in it anymore. I'm voting my conscience, and you know, I want to be true to myself and who I am and keep my dignity. Who cares? I'm voting strategically. So are they, and they still think I'm in the stupid alliance because if I told them I didn't want to be, they'd vote me off. So I'm trying to save my own ass. So how bold and wonderful is that? I don't care what I say to people. I don't care if I'm nice to anybody at camp anymore. I do not give a shit. And it feels so good. It's great, I love it. 24/7 is all I have to say.
Colleen, you need to bring me your torch.
Nice to each other, okay? That's weird.
Colleen, the tribe has spoken.
Don't worry about it. You have my word, and I gave it to you.
Rich is a smart guy, and he's really tricky. And I don't trust him one bit. I never really have.
Ratana Beach.
You did not tell him you were chicken. You told him you weren't aligned with us, because Colleen told me that.
That's bull.
Well, I don't give a because I trust her more than I trust you.
Why? That's bull.
I've been your friend since day one.
No, I'm going fishing.
That's bull. Will you talk to me?
No. I don't have to.
What did you just ask Sue?
How Sue feels that I have her or have the four of us. I don't understand what that's coming from because I tried to make the Pagong team think that we weren't going to eliminate them one by one. I thought that was part of the game. Sue said many times that she wasn't part of an alliance either. So now all of a sudden I'm two-faced and I her when she had approached me and said, hey, Rich and I have formed an alliance to vote you off at the end, but I'm not going to do that. Let's you and I vote him off. If I was trying to plot against you and plot against Sue and trying to use them in my best interest, then I would have voted for you. But I decided I wanted to stay true to our alliance, right, to our four that we decided on from the beginning.
Right. 5, 4, 3, 2, stop, stop, stop.
Don't you have to move over?
Stop bouncing.
Yeah.
Oh, this is so close.
15.9 for Kelly.
Give me a big hug,
Give me a big hug.
It feels good to, you know, win something. I haven't won much of anything. So I won yesterday and I won today. I feel better if it was an immunity that I won today. But hopefully I'm on a winning streak.
When we got back from the mud, we were washing, you know, helping each other get the mud off and things like that.
So how are you hanging in?
I'm doing good.
Yeah?
Yeah, the game's, you know, finally gotten weird. Finally gotten crazy, finally gotten intense.
Really?
I thought I could trust Sue, which was my first mistake. You can't trust anybody. I don't lose any respect for her for playing the game at all. We're not, you know, I said something today on the trail. I was like, wait a minute, we're not evil. We just play bad people on TV. Whether it's every man for himself or whatever, I would like to just move things over with Sue because that was just completely, there was nothing behind it.
It'd be interesting to see how this plays out.
I know.
Kelly Wigglesworth, a river guy in Las Vegas.
There's 4 days left and we're all still gonna have to live together, and Sue and I, we kind of patched things up, and you know, she said, hey, look, this is the game. I'm gonna have an alliance with Rich and instead of you. And I said, fine, you know, that's cool, play the game. I said, I think I deserve to get to the four and I think I deserve to get to the three. And she said, well, I'm not gonna let you. And it's the other way around. I'm not gonna let her.
What?
Yeah. Do you have all the answers?
Sure do.
Right on, let me see it. Four for four. Last one. I guess you get to keep this. There you go.
Good job, Kelly.
Nice job, Wigglesworth.
Rich has said since he knows that Sue was plotting an alliance against him, he has had to rearrange his strategy. So maybe they're not voting together. I don't know. To me, that just means game on. I'm gonna vote for either Rich or Sue. It's time to get dirty. No more Mr. Nice Guy. As I said, I don't know. It's every man for himself.
Kelly, how much did you need to win that immunity
challenge? Desperately.
You're convinced you were gone, if not?
Pretty much, yeah.
The situation we're in tonight, as a result, you go from somebody who might have well have been voted off to the absolute swing vote. You can't be voted on, but you're going to vote for somebody. Indeed. Did the mood around you change at all in the last day?
I'd say so, yeah. I think the mood, you know, pretty much everybody with the whole group and the new dynamics and 3 days left has changed quite a bit.
John. Need to bring me your torch. It went out during the vote.
No.
The tribe has spoken. The jungle has spoken. It's time for you to go.
I'm completely covered in bug bites from head to toe. I've lost some weight. I've lost some muscle. I've lost quite a hunk of sanity. Gosh, I don't think I thought this was going to be as mental as it ended up being. I feel like I
agreed to be an alliance, and then I didn't want to be in it anymore, but I was too chicken to tell him that. And I tried to play both sides. I tried to vote how I wanted to vote, do what I thought was right, but not let them in on it because, hell, I want to stay in the game. I just bit off way more than I could chew, and it just, it all exploded. I feel completely vulnerable. I feel an odd man out. It's really stressful, and it's kind of scary because, you know, I'm not safe anymore. The one person I did actually care about was Sue, and she doesn't give two f- about me, so I don't give a crap about anybody on this island anymore. I'm here for me, and everybody else can kiss my ass.
Sue, you don't know. Kelly, Christopher is right. Kelly, well done. Immunity.
Four in a row, Kelly.
You are on a hot streak, for sure. Do you pay attention to people usually and learn about them?
I do. I listen to people, and I especially listen when it's people I'm interested in and people I like. It's time for Mitch to get off the stage.
Rich.
Our first tie.
Sue.
Thanks, sweetie.
The tribe has spoken.
We'll see you guys later.
Swap.
He took his hand off.
I think that's that, brother.
Yeah. I'm done.
Nice job.
Nice job.
Nice job,
brother. Hug time.
Oh,
there you go. Five and
that's
a row.
That's a record.
I knew 100% the only way that I was going to get to day 38, and now tomorrow, day 39, was with this little thing around my neck. So Rich just gave a little speech and said, I hope you appreciate what I'm doing for the both of you and let go, which I thought was kind of funny. Like, he was tired, his arm hurt, he wanted to let go, and he was trying to make some big noble sacrifice for me and Rudy. Yeah, whatever. So when I went today, it was just like, okay, that's it. Chill out, relax, breathe, sleep, whatever you gotta do. So it was just unbelievable, overwhelming sense of relaxation and relief. I'm nervous. I'm not nervous about the vote tonight. I'm extremely nervous about tomorrow. I'm nervous about if and what I'm going to say tomorrow and what impact and effect that's going to have on the jury.
The 14th person voted off the island is Rudy. In this case, Kelly has spoken.
Woke up, and it was very weird. Rich had said to me, okay, you're not dreaming, it's the last day, and it's really just us two. This is just where I like to be. This is where I prefer to stretch and chill out and do my thing. My last little yoga session here on the beach is something that I've done pretty much every day since I've been here. It helps me to relax and to quiet my thoughts. I've had a lot of moral issues. I regret being part of the alliance. That didn't make me feel so good. I regret trusting Sue, being vulnerable to her. That really hurt me in a lot of ways. But it's been really hard mentally. People trying to my brain is just I can't think about anything really right now. There's been some moral low points for me in playing this game. I've had some kind of not so proud moments, and that's things that I'm leaving here on this island and with this game, and that don't belong in my life. I'm really grateful I'm here. I feel lucky to be in the final two. I'm nervous about the decision tonight because Rich never pretended that he wasn't in it to win. And he never pretended that he wasn't scheming and conniving and all of that from the beginning. He's playing the game and he's never acted like he wasn't. So I do respect that.